Okay, people, I just watched a rambling by Dr. David Wood, you know, the Wood Doctor. He was rambling about that the Quran had been shredded, you know. I don't know what he meant by the Quran had been shredded. That means the Quran had been vanished. And who shredded the Quran? Is it the goat that eat the some of the verses? Okay. Okay, basically he quoted Surah 15:15, and he only quoted two verses, 90 and 91. Okay, I read to you the Yusuf Ali translation, okay? Or just such wrath as we send down on those who divided scriptures into arbitrary parts. Okay, and then 91, so also on such as we have made Quran into shreds as they please, you know. You see, if the deaf, the dumb and the blind try to interpret this verse, he said that the Quran was shredded into trash. So he argued that then how can Muslim have a non-corrupted Quran, you know? Okay, but actually this whole verse, the context of this verse, starting from verse 87, let me read to you, okay, or even 86 for 86 to 93, the whole context. Okay, for verily it is thy Lord who is the master creator, knowing all things. And 87, and we have bestowed upon thee the seven of repeated verses and the grand Quran. So what are the seven repeated, often repeated verses? The seven often repeated verses is the Al-Fatiha, the opening. If you recite that seven verse, you have actually recite the whole grand Quran, you know, in terms of grace. That's why you no need to worry if the rest of the Quran are lost. It doesn't matter, because the first seven verse is the gist of the Quran, okay? And then it's 88, strain not thine eyes wistfully at what we have bestowed on certain classes of them, nor grieve over them, but lower thy wing, I mean, in gentleness to the believers, the Muslim, and say, I am indeed he that wants openly and without ambiguity. And then come 90, of just such wrath as we send down on those who divided scriptures into arbitrary parts. Who are those that God previously sent down scriptures? Those are the Torah and the Gospel. Remember, they did divide the Gospel, you know, into contrary parts. That's why you find contradictory verses in the Gospel, you know. Okay. 91, so also on such as have made Quran into shreds, there are those, you know, Muslim, and then they become apostate, you know, and then they shredded some parts of the Quran. But of course Allah will preserve the Quran. And 92, therefore by the Lord we will of a surety call them to account. And 93, for all their deeds. So I don't know what the Dr. Wood, okay, Dr. Wood was rambling about. He was saying that the Quran has been shredded just because he took the word verbatim from the verse, you know, as have made Quran into shreds. So he thought according to his limited thinking, okay, that the Quran had been vanished. No, but earlier on Allah said, I have bestowed you with the 7 often repeated verses. That means the Al-Fatiha is the gist of the Quran. Okay? And for a surety, Allah will preserve the Quran, you know? So basically, Dr. David Wood was rambling for nothing, you know, like a dog barking, you know, barking at the wrong tree. I don't know what he was actually getting into, but actually he was saying, he was accusing that the Muslim accused the people of the book, you know, for reciting from the book which was not written in the book, and then the Muslim call it, oh, because of that the people of the book had corrupted the original verses, you know. And then David Wood was saying that, oh, because Muslim have a double standard, no? But when the Muslim say something to the same effect, he quoted that the ISIS, the Boko Haram misinterpret the Quran, then they say the Quran also had been corrupted, you know. No, why they say the ISIS and the Boko Haram, by that account, never, it was the Quran was not corrupted by them, you know. Now there is a big difference, you know. During those people of the book time, 90%, in fact less, more of the people, they were illiterate, you know. So when the priest read to them what was actually not written in the actual verse, and then they say something to that effect, the listeners will gather and capture the memory of those words. And then when they started to learn, become literate, and then they later on write whatever the priest had taught them, that is, that means the later versions of the scripture are corrupted in that sense, you know. But now it's different. Now it's only that the people who mistranslate the Quran, misinterpret the Quran, and then they become terrorists, you know. They did not corrupt the Quran, they corrupt themselves, you know, because most of the time they are actually following the hadith, you know. They are following the imams, they never follow the Quran, they are following their imams. They are relying on the hadith, you know. When Allah said, this is the book, this is guidance, the book is referring to the Quran. This is guidance to those who fear Allah. Then if the ISIS or the Boko Haram decided to ignore the Quran, only refer to hadith, and then they are misguided, and that's why they become terrorists. So that does not mean the Quran had been corrupted, okay? So David Wood, try to get your rambling in the correct context, you know. Otherwise, don't just bark like a dog, you know. After all, you are also the wood dog, you know, the wood doctor, okay? So I hope I have make it clear, okay? Okay, thank you very much.